all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Verstappen, Perez, and Carlos Sainz. Goodbye for now then, but we are really just getting started. Hello and welcome to the Ile Notre Dame once again for what promises to be another incredible Canadian Grand Prix at a fiercely competitive circuit where pole position can often be decided by less than a tenth of a second. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. World champion Max Verstappen starts from pole position. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Sainz, Hamilton, George Russell, and Leclerc. Norris, the captain, Fernando Alonso, and Daniel Ricciardo. Ocon, Gasly, Valtteri Bottas, and Tsunoda. Vettel, Magnussen, Guan Yu Zhou, and Mick Schumacher. Albon, Stroll, Fittipaldi, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, gap ahead. ahead is 16.4 seconds. Some information on Perez. He seems to have an issue. Lap, give us the best in lap you can. About the tyre condition for now, everything's looking good. And the gap to the car in front is 19.8 seconds.
Like the pit crew are out in the lane and ready to perform their magic on the car. They're going to be aiming to achieve the fastest pit stop time possible.
Look after these tyres now, and you want to finish the race on this compound. Enzo's in the pits. Enzo is in the pits now. got enough fuel for three more laps. Okay, gap ahead is 6.2 seconds. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining.
It then for another magnificent Canadian Grand Prix, and they have hung on to take a sublime victory here today. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out of the track was: speed. It sounds like an awfully reductive statement, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. It's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Let's focus on Driver of the Day, Natalie Pinkham. Come on, who do you pick?
It's got to be Lewis Hamilton. I mean, he pulled off some impressive feats out there on track today, even by his high standards.
Let's move on to the Constructors. Red Bull pull further ahead in the standings. Meanwhile, AlphaTauri's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. Been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next. Thank you.
We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for this weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen. Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.